On the backcourt, and her pass is tipped away quickly by Malco, and she picks up in the backcourt. She has a stolen back by Redwick, who gives to Tram, and she travels. I think there was three turnovers in a matter of 2 seconds there.
Did I jinx us?
I think you did.
By that pregame statement.
Well.
Okay. When am I going to come out in a man-to-man? Well, no, 1-2-1-1 half-court trap.
Eleni Shrove tries to pass at three-quarter court to Laney Smith, and it's tipped out of bounds on the far side by McGovern, I believe. It'll stay with Rochester on the far side. 10 seconds gone here in the opening quarter. Shrove gets it into Holland. And Winnemac, as Tony Stasiak expected, in that 2-3 zone. Ball loose from the floor. It's going to be tied up. Rochester getting to keep possession.
You know, forcing those passes right there, I mean, that's just the type of turnovers we were talking about. Luckily, we got the ball back on the jump ball.
Yeah.
But, you know, you can't force those this early in the ball game.
Shrove gets it into Holland again. Rochester working to the right. Riley Holland behind the arc. Now in the paint. Kicks it back outside to Malco. Before she does, she travels. So I believe that's probably about two turnovers apiece right now in a span of about 30 seconds.
Rochester going to come out in a man-to-man full-court press.
Tram has it. Gives it shorter. Gives ahead to McGovern. Now crosses the timeline to Redwick. Redwick against Shrove. Being a double team, she loses the handle. Picks it up. Runs the right baseline. Skip pass is kicked away by Crispin, and it'll stay with Winnemac baseline left. 7:24 to play in the first quarter, no score.
Good job by Jenna Crispin to fill those passing lanes. Even though she didn't get the ball, she was able to prevent that easy layup underneath the basket.
So Jessica Schramm, baseline left, looks to get it in. Does so to Redwick, being chased by Shrove, and the pass is off the hands of McGovern, hauled down to the corner. Winnemac still with the basketball, going to our right. Now Schramm, lob pass down low to Shorter. Shorter against Crispin, turnaround jumper from 10 feet, no good. Offensive rebound to Ansball. The three-pointer by Redwick is no good. Again, offensive rebound by Schramm. The putback is no good, but Jessica Schramm will go to the line to shoot two for the Lady Warriors.
Obviously, the offensive rebounding right now for Winnemac is just stellar. That's three offensive rebounds for him already.
Well, that was one thing that Coach Stasiak said in our pregame show is Lewis Cass had too many second and third and fourth opportunities, and right now on this trip, Winnemac has had two.
On two, then we picked up a foul on Jenna Crispin, her first team's first, as Schramm does miss the first of the two-shot free foul.
Jessica Schramm, a 5'6 junior for the Lady Warriors, at the line for one more. Schramm ready, right-handed free throw on the way. It is good this time, and Winnemac up 1-0, and Austin in that full-court press. Almost a zone press, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a 1-2-1-1.
Holland breaks the press, gives to Crispin. Crispin in the paint, throws up a shot. It is good as it rolls around and falls through.
A good, strong move by Crispin there. She got the pass on the low block, one up over the Winnemac defender, able to get it to go over the front of the rim.
So Winnemac on the press breaker. Ansball throws it over the hands of Redwick out of bounds. That's another turnover on the Lady Warriors. 2-1 Rochester, and like Austin said before, Winnemac in that zone of press.
Now they're in a 3-1-1.
Yeah.
I don't know if I've ever seen that one.
No look pass to Smith. Laney Smith holds way outside right.
Ooh.
To Malco. Get past to Crispin. Layup is good.
I tell you what, if Malco didn't make that pass, we were going to get on for not taking that open jump shot. But great pass down to Crispin on the low block.
Redrick breaks the pressure on her own. And now the double team in the corner loses the basketball, picks it up, gives to McGovern. And McGovern is sent out. Ooh, yeah.
12-2 on Crispin.
By Jenna Crispin, and that was just a hustle foul right there. But quickly, that's going to send Coach Stasiak to the bench, and Rayan Hunter will come in for Crispin, who has 4 points and now two fouls.
The one thing I do like, that's one reason, that's why the press is so effective, the Lady Zebras, forcing Winnemac to make those quick decisions, and usually ends up in a turnover.
So the Lady Warriors of the basketball going to our right. Redwick has it behind the arc. Three on the way is good.
Wow, that's a great shot by Redwick. Got the pass off the inbound, able to drain the three in the corner.
So quick. Catch and shoot is so quick. Smith has it. Laney gets a double team, throws it right into the hands of Winnemac, and Redwick coming the other way. Sarah Redwick pushes off, pulls up for 15 feet, jumper's no good, short, and Laney Smith clears the board and gives to Malco. We're tied at four here at Rochester. It's 5:50 to play in the first quarter. Lady Zebras with the basketball going to our left. Holland high on the right side for Rochester. Splits the double team. Has it poked away. Picked up by Winnemac and Schramm. Now ahead to Redwick. Sarah Redwick pushes through the middle of the floor. Picks up a dribble.
Double dribbles. She didn't have a lot of help there, and she picked up her dribble. Nobody came back to help her out.
That's exactly what Coach Wagner says. Hey, that's not her fault. Nobody came to help her. So another turnover for the Lady Warriors. Rochester has it back. We're tied at four with 5.5 to play the first quarter. Holland, left side to Malco. Just inside the arc. Her jumper's on the way. It's off the back of the rim. No good. Long rebound hauled in by Schroff. Eleni Schroff with it. Fakes. Feeds down low to Smith. Smith backs away in the lane. The baby hook is on the way. No good. And the rebound to Schroff. Now outside to Malco. Quickly left side to Holland. Three on the way. Left wing. No good off the back of the iron. Holland with the rebound and it's fouled. Going to the basket. And it'll be out of bounds to Rochester baseline left.
I know we didn't get a bucket there, but good offensive possession for the Lady Eagles. I thought against that zone, which is forcing that outside jump shot, three really good looks for the Lady Zs.
Three offensive rebounds on that trip alone for the Rochester Lady Zebras. And they'll have possession baseline right as a foul coming against
Schramm.
Schramm.
Her first team first.
B. Pollock gets the inbound pass from Malco and puts it in for a quick two. It's 6-4, Rochester.
Nobody watching B. Pollock right underneath the low block on the basket. That was an easy one for Malco.
And now Asphalt throws the basketball off the hands of Redwick and out of bounds. Nice pressure by the Lady Zebras. Another turnover on Winnemac. Bethany Brogdon comes into the game for the first time, and McGovern will sit.
A couple jump shots we missed early, must have what I noticed between Holland and Malco. Last game I saw, their jump shots were coming up short. Those jump shots were in and out.
Yeah.
Like they must have been working on their jump shots a lot.
Schroff for three is good.
Good shot by Eleni Schroff in the wing. Hits the tray.
Brogdon has the basketball, leads ahead. To Schramm. Schramm in the corner against a double team. A lot of contact. No foul. Now outside high on the left side to Brogdon. Now right side to Shorter. Shorter against Hunter. Her jumper's good.
That was a good move there by Shorter to take it up against Rianne Hunter. Try to draw the contact.
A little full-court press by the Lady Warriors. Baseball pass to Hunter. Her left-handed layup is up and good.
Real quick to break that one-two-one-one zone that Winnemac is playing.
And now we're going to have a foul in the push by the Rochester Lady Zebras. It'll be out of bounds to Winnemac right in front of the scorer's table. And Abby Malco will pick up that foul. Team third with 4:18 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 11-6.
Zebras going to stay with some pressure here.
Redwick gets it into Brogdon, who will run the point against Malco. Brogdon right side, now crossover dribble, left hand goes to the left side. Now crosses, switches directions, comes to the right side, gives to Redwick. Lob pass down a little shorter, tipped away by Hunter, back in the hands of Redwick. Jump pass in the lane to Schramm, her jumper from the free throw line is no good. Great block out by Schroff. She grabs the board and clears herself.
Schroff and Holland has switched up on Redwick. Holland now guarding Redwick.
And now we're going to have a foul coming against Tara Redwick, and that's going to send Coach Wagner to the bench again. And Whitney Hook, a 5'5 junior, will come into the game for the first time tonight. And Hook will replace.
Was that more of a frustration foul, Redwick?
Oh, absolutely.
Kind of what it looked like on the offensive side. And she just basically, you know, gave a little bit of a shoulder block there.
Sarah Redwick sets down for the first time tonight. So Rochester has it by five. Going to our left. Malco for three. Left wing. Good!
Great shot by Malco. She got her feet set. Able to get her hand right behind that basketball. Nothing but net.
Full court press again. Brogdon breaks it easily. She crosses the timeline right. Now in front of the Rochester bench. Gets it off to Hook. Hook, one dribble. Now to Schramm. High on the left side of the volleyball line. Lob pass down low. Tipped in the air. Ansball has it. Outside to Brogdon. Brogdon works the right baseline. Jump pass down low to Hook. Hook pulls it back outside to Schramm. Runs around the defense. In doing so, she forgot to dribble. She travels and to go back to the Rochester Lady Zebras.
I tell you what, one thing I've noticed with the Zebras on the offensive side, they're a little bit calmer, making some good crisp pass, making sure they find this open jump shot against that zone.
3:18 to play first quarter. Rochester by eight. Holland works to the wing. Gives to Malco high on the left side. Now wide open is Schroff. Eleni studies, works against Hook, bounce pass on the baseline to Holland. Holland now to Hunter. Hunter around the defense, throws up a baby hook off the side of the backboard, no good. And Winnemac and Brogdon with the board. Bethany Brogdon ahead, has her pass stolen by Schroff, now to Malco. 2-on-1 break, Malco stops, pops, nope. Rebound to Ansball, nope, make that to Schramm, and Schramm runs it up the left side of the floor. Cut off by the defense and Schroff outside to Brogdon. Brogdon feeds down low to Shorter. Shorter over the double team. She's fouling a shot. Shorter to the line for two.
I think the foul's going to be on Rian Hunter, and I have not figured out how Shorter can get that kind of position on Rian Hunter. I haven't figured it out yet.
shorter is 5'9". Rayanne Hunter is 6 foot. So giving up a few inches, but you're right. She does a great job getting position on the block.
She's got position every time they come down the court.
Shorter's first free throw is no good. So I have another one. Kaylee Smith for Rochester coming in. Rayanne Hunter will sit. Also back into the game is McGovern, and Anspaugh will sit down. Austin Shepherd, I'm David Musselman. We're in the first quarter here at Rochester. Zebras lead 14-6 with 2:43 to play in the first quarter. Second one by Shorter is good this time. 14-7, no pressure as Holland brings the ball up the court. Brogdon will pick her up at the volleyball line. Holland walks through the center circle, works to the right side, down low to Pollock. Pollock loses the basketball in the lane, but right in the hands of Holland, picks it up, it's good!
I tell you what, Holland just in the right place at the right time. She was trailing on the baseline, got the pass in her lap, and kisses it off the glass.
Schramm against the double team, high on the left side, got to get rid of it. Finally does the Brogdon at the free throw at the volleyball line. Jump pass down to Shorter, her turnaround, jumper's good!
Tell you what, Shorter just finds a way to get open on the low block, and that one was just as academic as can be.
Stephanie Shorter, another bucket for her. As Malco spotted for a three, right side, good again!
I tell you what, I haven't seen Malco shoot like this in a while.
Haven't either. Rochester now up by 10 at 19-9, under 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Malco now in the jersey of Brogdon, and we're going to have a foul coming against Kaylee Smith, I would think. Nice body check here right in front of the Rochester bench. And knock Bethany Brogdon to the floor and the ball out of bounds, and it will be a foul on Smith. And back into the game is Sarah Redwick, and coming out is Hook. Lainey Smith back into the game. Kaylee Smith will sit down, and she gets an earful from Coach Stasiak, which is
she was out of position there, and they were trying to do a little bit of a trap there on the ball handler.
So 1:51 to play in the first quarter, Rochester by 10, and Schramm and Schroff just about tied the ball up. Winnemack with the basketball, Shorter on the block, turnaround jumper over Smith, partially blocked, picked up by Pollock. B. Pollock now off to Schroff. And Rochester will bring it up the floor, up 19-9 with 1:35 to play in the first quarter. Trofe works right side, now left side to Malco, who has been hot from behind the arc. Drives the baseline, pull up 10-footer, short, and the rebound is Shorter. Stephanie Shorter for the Lady Warriors now clears to Redwick, and the Lady Warriors run. Going to our right to Schramm. Schramm against Pollock on the right baseline, cut off by the defense, now sends top of the key to Brogdon. Brogdon holds behind the arc, she fires a three, it's off the back of the iron, no good. Rebound to McGovern, gives back to Brogdon. Brogdon, lob pass down low to Shorter, and she is fouled. No, I beg your pardon. That's going to be a lob pass to Redwick, and she is fouled.
The foul's going to be on Bree Pollock, her first team sixth.
1:07 to play. First quarter, Rochester by 10 at 19-9. Redwick looks to get it in. Sarah studies. Finally gets it into Schramm behind the arc on the right wing. Feeds down low to Shorter. Shorter shot over Smith is good. The foul.
I'll tell you what, Shorter just able to find a way to get position that time on the even taller Lainey Smith. And she takes it up, gets the bucket to go, and is going to be fouled and go line here for three-point play.
Rayanne Hunter will come back into the game for Rochester. It's 19-11, Rochester lead. And Stephanie Shorter at the line for one free throw to try to complete the three-point play the old-fashioned way. Austin Shepherd, I'm David Musselman. We have seen a pretty good first quarter here by both teams. Shorter's free throw is good, and it's 19-12. Rochester has the basketball in the lead. Riley Holland will walk it up the floor. She'll walk it right through the center circle, and the 1-3-1 zone from Winnemack will be awaiting her. Malco at the volleyball line, high on the right side with 50 seconds. Malco back to Holland with 48. Riley, one dribble to Schroff in the left corner with 45. Trove now the wing, fake the pass, now to Holland on the 42 at the left side. Holland back to Schroff with 38. Gives to Malco in the middle of the rings with 35. Gives down to Holland. She'll go to the rack. Her jumper on the way, no good. Rebound tipped around, and Redwick and the Lady Warriors at the basketball. Now to Shorter, back to Sarah Redwick with 25. Rochester up by 7. Now to Schramm, high on the left side for the Lady Warriors. Works right side, picked up the dribble, and Hunter in her face. And her pass is knocked out of bounds by Holland on the far side, right in front of the student bench with 17.3 to play in the first quarter. Rochester by 7.
17 seconds to go here in the first quarter. I would think the ball's either going to go down to Shorter. It's got it.
I would agree. Redwick back to Schramm. 3 left side is good.
Or, hey, Schramm could just step back and hit a nice three.
19-15. Holland on the run with 4. At the volleyball line with 3. Holland right side and travels. Gives to Hunter. Out to Schroff. 3 at the buzzer. No good. After one, Rochester leads 19-15. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
It's a whole new attitude at Shepherd's, and that's the way we stay. It's a whole new attitude at Shepherd's, Shepherd Chevrolet.
It's Malibu Mania at Shepherd Chevrolet in Rochester. Hi, this is Austin. We have over 10 pre-owned Malibus in stock ready to go. How about a 2011 Malibu LTZ, original sticker price $32,500, now only $21,985. Or a 2011 Malibu LT, original sticker price $26,900, now only $19,985. Looking for a low monthly payment? Take a look at our 2008 Malibu, only $259 per month. Or our 2010 Malibu for only $279 a month. Shepherd Chevrolet in Rochester, your certified pre-owned headquarters. Stop in and talk to Jay, Dale, Jesse, Eddie, Bobby, or me, Austin. Shepherd Chevrolet is the corner of State Road 25 North and 14 East, Rochester, where you always feel like family.
Shepherd Chevrolet.
All payments based on 4.99% APR for 72 months. Sales tax down with approved credit.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
For high school, we're going to the second quarter. The Lady Zebras, once led by 10, now down to 4. Great shooting from the outside by the Lady Warriors, and another big three by Schramm as the quarter came to a close, Austin.
I tell you what, if you would have told me Rochester's going to put up 19 points in the first quarter, I would have told you you're nuts.
Especially coming off 36 the whole game.
Exactly. But I tell you what, the first, out of that 8 minutes, the first 7 minutes of that quarter, as best I've seen Rochester play all year, or heard him play all year, but now the last minute, we let him score some points.
Yep.
Rochester's going to come out in a 2-3 zone to try to switch it up a little bit.
Redvick for three, no good. Offensive rebound by Shorter, and we're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to go to Rochester. The first quarter shooting for the Lady Zebras, 5 of 12 from inside the arc for 42%, 3 of 4 from behind the arc, 75%, 8 of 16 overall. They had 4 turnovers, 3 offensively and defensively rebounds. For Winnemac, they were 5 of 11 overall, 45%, 3 of 8 inside the arc, 2 of 3 outside the arc, 3 of 5 from the free throw line, and 7 turnovers in that first quarter. Schroff drives the left baseline, pull up from 15 feet short, and the rebound to Pollock. Pollock, she'll put it back up, partially blocked. Hunter grabs the rebound, kicks it out to Malco, now right side to Holland. Riley Holland dribbles on the right side, gives left side to Malco, spots up for a 3, left side, good again!
I tell you what, Malco's just dialed in from behind the line. She's 3 of 4.
At least 9 tonight, and it's 22-15, back to a 7-point lead for the Lady Zebras.
And I like the idea of going to this 2-3 zone, much by Coach Jaziak. It's going to force the ball outside of the paint.
And Brogdon's entry pass into McGovern is tipped away by Schroff, and it'll be out of bounds to Winnemac baseline right. I agree with you.
Yeah, try to take the ball out of Shorter's hands here, going to this 2-3 zone.
What does she have in the first quarter?
Shorter had 8.
Wow, really? And now we're going to have a foul before the ball even gets in play by
offensive.
Brogdon. On a legal screen, and Rochester going to get it back on the turnover by the Lady Warriors. With 7 minutes to play in the first half, up by 7.
Her first foul, team's third.
So Riley Holland will walk the ball up for the Lady Zebras, walking to our left. She'll walk it right through the center circle, and she'll look right into that 1-3-1 zone. Holland left side, now gives off to Malco. Malco, she'll dribble between the rings, now works to the right wing. Cut off by the defense, works to the free throw line, now in the lane, cuts it out to Schroff. Schroff fires from just inside the arc, so no good. Hunter with the rebound. Ran Hunter, the baby hook in the lane, is no good, in and out. And the rebound now to Redwick and Winnemac. Sarah Redwick runs up the floor against Schroff, works to the right side, around the defense, down the lane. Leaner off the window is going to be no good, but a foul coming in Rochester, and Sarah Redwick will go to the line to shoot two.
I didn't see who they're going to get. It's either going to be a Schroff or Ray and Hunter on the foul.
And it's going to be B. Pollock.
Okay, or it could be B. Pollock for
well,
second.
Here's what I saw there. On the shot, Redwick grabbed the rebound, and there was just a look in her eyes that she was going to the basket.
She took it coast to coast.
Free throw by Redwick is good. She'll have one more. Carly Murphy will come into the game for the first time tonight. Carly Murphy is a 5'7 sophomore, and B. Pollock with 2 personal fouls will sit down. Now there's a little bit of a foul issue right now for Lady Zebras.
With B. Pollock and Crispin, and I thought B. Pollock came and it had a really good first quarter there, Moss.
I agree. Second one, no good, but Shorter with the rebound. The putback is good.
Nobody blocked out Shorter. She goes right around, and that was just that's academic right there.
22-18. Rochester with the basketball on the lead. Holland works left side, just inside the arc. Jumper off the side of the iron, no good. Schramm with the board, gives to Redwick. Now quickly ahead to Brogdon. Brogdon on the left side, gives to Cuddy McGovern. McGovern then has a strip by Murphy, and then we're going to have a foul. It's going to say last touch by McGovern. It's going to go back to Rochester. And back into the game is Katie Anspaugh, and setting down is Shorter.
I wouldn't say Shorter's going to be on the bench too long here.
I would
probably
think so.
A quick breather.
Especially if this one gets away from Winamac on the post. 22-18 Rochester, 6 to play in the first half. Malco holds high on the right side. Winamac now is going to come out of that 1-1-3.
It's a 1-3-1.
Strofe out to Malco near the volleyball line. Now works to the corner. Abby dribbles back to the wing. Now the middle of the floor. Left side now in the paint. Outside to Riley Holland. Fakes the three. At the elbow. Throws up a shot. It's off high off the glass and in. It goes for two.
And like I said, she called bank on that one. She hits it high off the square.
Rochester now back in front with by six. Redwick gives to Brogdon. Top of the key between the rings. Now left side to Schramm. Back to Brogdon. 5:15 to play. First half. Rochester up 24-18. Anspaugh turnaround jumper on the block. No good. Rebound by Hunter. And she clears to Holland. Riley Holland walks it up the floor for Rochester. Going to our left. She's at the volleyball line now. Now between the rings. Top of the key. Works to the wing. Nice job by Brogdon cutting off the passing lane. Outside to Murphy. Now to Malco for three again. No good. Hunter with the rebound. The putback by Rand Hunter is no good. She gets her own rebound back again. And kicks it out to Malco. Malco around the defense in the lane. The leaner on the way is no good, but a foul coming on Winamac, and that's going to send Malco to the line for two.
I tell you what, we can't get Rhiann Hunter to make a bucket underneath the basket, but she still keeps working, pulling down those offensive rebounds. And that time she kicked it out to Malco, and Malco took it right to the bucket and drew the foul. And she's going to go line here for two free throws.
Malco's three was on line. That one's going.
Looked good from this side of the gym, you're right.
Abby Malco has two for the Lady Zebras. First one of the way for the senior is good. 25-18, 4:44 to play in the second quarter. And Rochester with the lead.
And that was the first free throw attempt of the game by Rochester.
Where Winamac has attempted at least five. Second
seven.
By the senior. Good again. Seven, okay. 26-18, back to an 8-point lead for Rochester. It has been as big a 10 in the first quarter. Redwick ahead. Sarah Redwick will go coast to coast. The fallaway jumper on the baseline is no good. Rebound tipped around. Schroff comes out of there with it. And now Lainey Schroff misses a streaking Carly Murphy down the floor, but better safe than sorry. She keeps possession of it and dribbles it up the floor, works to the right side. Now to Holland, outside right behind the arc. Holland looks at a three. Defense backs off over, gives to Hunter. Hunter loses the handle, now gives to Malco. Malco, no look pass to Holland. Three on the way, right side. Good!
Wow, good job by Riley Holland to get her feet set. Malco put the pass right on the money, and that was easy for her.
29-18. Rochester on top. McGovern over the defense, and we're going to have a foul on the shot, and that's going to be Schroff or either Hunter. Regardless, that's going to send Steph McGovern to the line to shoot two.
I think it's going
to
be on Schroff. She's going to say she came over the back.
3 minutes, 59 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester up by 11 at 29-18.
Redwood going to go to the line. Is Redwood going to have the ball?
At the line for Winamac, shooting two.
I didn't think it was either.
So regardless, Redwick will go to the line now, I guess. A 5'6 senior to shoot two. Man, I thought it was McGovern too. First one is good by the senior. She'll have one more. Back into the game is Shorter, and Anspaugh will sit down. 3:59 to play in the first half. Rochester by 10 coming up at halftime. Junior varsity coach Randy Wynn. We'll talk about his and their big win tonight. Second is good again by Redwick. ...29-20. Rochester on top. 3:50 to play in the first half. Zone defense again by the Lady Warriors. Malco high on the right side. Baseball pass on the near side to Holland. Back to Malco high on the right side again.
They're trying to force that zone to come out and guard him, which opens up the middle.
Well, Rochester up by 9. It's easy to do that.
Exactly.
You just hold the ball because you really don't need to score again, right? Holland?
Your technicality, you're right, Mike.
Thank you. Malco at the volleyball line has her pass stripped away out of bounds by Redwick, and it'll stay with Rochester right on the far side. 3:25 to play in the first half. Rochester up by 9 at 29-20. Holland, no-look pass into Malco. Drives the baseline, and she is fouled going to the basket by Redwick, and I believe that'll be number two on Sarah Redwick.
It is number two, and I tell you what, it happened. You say that no-look pass by Holland. Redwick was watching Holland. Holland was looking at Schroff, Malco snuck out over there on the wing, and all she could do was give her a hip check. If she didn't, she was going to blow right by her for a wide-open layup.
Malco lobs it over the defense to Schroff. Back to Malco in the corner. Oh, she thought about a three. She passes it up. Now gives to Schroff way outside left. Schroff at the volleyball line now. Gives to Holland the volleyball line right. 3:13 to play in the first half. Rochester by 9. Holland gives to Malco. Runs the right baseline. Cut off by the defense. And now gives left side to Schroff. To Holland. Three on the way. Left side for the Lady Zebras is in and out. No good. Murphy, the putback is no good. And the rebound to Redwick. Sarah Redwick runs. Rochester down by 9. Now Schroff steals the basketball. Eleni Schroff will go in. Right-handed layup is good.
I tell you what, good job by Schroff there. What had happened is Redwick lost control of that basketball, and Eleni Schroff was all over it.
Brogdon sends left side to Redwick. Back to Brogdon between the rings. Now right side to Schramm. Schramm looking down little McGovern. Has her in the block. Shot partially blocked. Shorter picks up the ball, and then she is fouling the shot. I tell you what, McGovern spent a lot of time in the paint that time with no call, and Shorter got the tipped rebound, and she'll go to the line for two.
Foul's going to be on Carly Murphy, her first team's 10th. It was on the shot, so it's going to be two shots anyways for Shorter. Number
24, Stephanie Shorter, a 5'9 sophomore at the line for two. First one on the way is in and out and back in. Hook for Winnemac back in. Redwick will sit. Laney Smith back for Rochester, and Murphy will come out. Austin Shepherd, I'm David Musselman. Fourth game of the regular season for Rochester, sixth for the Winnemac Lady Warriors. Shorter, ready for the second one, fires it again, it's good. 31-22, Rochester's lead cut to 9. And now some full court pressure. Nope, I guess there was no full court pressure. Coach Wagner said, get back. We don't want him to break the press that easily. Hunter to Schroff, outside to Malco. Stands at the volleyball line, high on the right wing. One dribble, now to Holland. 31-22 Rochester, 2:10 to play in the first half. Malco around the defense, gives to Holland. Holland stops, pops, blocked by Shorter, picked up by Winnemac and Schramm. Schramm, left side, down to the baseline to Hook. Back to Schramm. The layup is good.
Good job by Schramm. Nice little give and go. She passed, cut immediately to the basket, and able to get the left-handed layup.
31-24. Rochester's lead now down to 7 with 1:40 to play in the first half. Malco now to Hunter. Stands behind the arc on the right wing. Rand Hunter, a couple of dribbles over the defense to Malco. Malco between the circles, now left side to Holland. 1:30 to play in the first half. Holland, and then it is hand-checked by Hook, and it's going to be out of bounds to the Lady Zebras with 1:28 to play in the first half.
Whitney Hook's first foul, team 6. Next foul will put Rochester in the 1-1 bonus.
Kaylee Smith back into the game. Riley Holland will sit down. 31-24, Rochester on top by 7. And Katie Anspaugh will come back into the game for Winnemac, and McGovern will sit down. So Schroff will look to get it in on the far side of the gym on the sideline. Schroff bounced past him, Malco, and she has it tipped out of bounds by Brogdon. And now it'll be all out of bounds on the inline. Malco will be the trigger person to get it in. Malco gets it into Hunter near the timeline. Ray and Hunter pushes off, no call, now to Malco. Now to Schroff from the left side. Eleni, a couple of dribbles to the middle of the floor with 1:15 to play in the first half. Eleni Schroff then has her pocket picked. She picks up the loose basketball and then is fouled by Hook, and Eleni Schroff will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
I tell you what, Hook there did a good job poking the ball away, but she just didn't follow up with it.
Yeah, and then she got to the ball as soon as Schroff did, and then got a foul called on her 75 feet away from the basket. Holland back into the game, and Hunter will sit. 1:12 to play in the first half. Rochester up 31-24. Eleni Schroff at the line to shoot one and the bonus for her Lady Zebras.
Eleni's first trip to the line tonight.
Schroff ready. The senior sets herself, fires it. No good. And the rebound to Shorter. Gives off to Schramm, and Schramm has a strip from behind by Holland and picked up by Malco. 60 seconds to play, first half, Rochester by 7. Malco high on the right side, and Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's try for one. Malco around Brogdon, gives to Schroff, fakes the three on the baseline. Delaney, bounce pass to Malco, top of the key. Now left side to Holland. Holland around the defense in the lane, out to Malco with 45. Back to Holland with 40. Holland works against Hook, who has three personal fouls, I believe, works to the right side. And now Rochester almost tied up. Kaylee Smith now has it, now to Schroff with 30. Delaney Schroff back to Holland with 28. 31-24 Rochester's. Time ticking away here in the second quarter. Holland picks up her dribble, gives to Malco with 20. Long three for the seniors, short, and the rebound to Anspaugh, who gives off to Brogdon with 14. Bethany Brogdon with 13. Brogdon dribbles with 10. Now to Hook, just inside the arc. Jumper's no good, and the rebound to Winamac is tied up between Smith and Shorter. And it'll be out of bounds to Winamac baseline left.
I'll tell you what, good job there by Eleni Schroff and Smith to come down and force that jump ball.
Hook looks to get it in for Winamac. Hook dumps down low to Shorter. Shorter shot, no good. Rebound by Shorter. The putback is no good. And the rebound by Anspaugh. Her putback is good.
Anspaugh goes up over the back of Eleni Smith there and pulls that down. And Coach Stasiak is furious.
At halftime, Rochester leads 31-26. Back with the more of the halftime show after this on 92.1 WOR.
But she's out here to start the second half.
Rochester will start the second half of the basketball. Malco fakes the three, runs around the defense, goes to the rack. It's short. The shot is short. Rebound by Anspaugh and the Lady Warriors. Now to Redwick. Rochester up 31-26. We'll get to the shooting stats here momentarily. Left side now to McGovern. Now to Schramm. Long three is good.
Schramm came around the screen there. She was able to get both of her feet set and take her time on the shot. She was able to bury the three out of the corner.
Rochester's lead cut to two, 31-29. In that first half, Winamac shot 3 of 5 from behind the arc for 40% from the floor in general. As B. Pollock has it in the paint, her leaner on the way. It's off the glass. It's good. B. Pollock with two more, 33-29.
Good job by B. Pollock. They're able to make room for herself down on that low block and get a good quality shot off.
Winamac from the floor in the first half shot 8 of 20 for 40%, 8 of 11 from the free throw line for 73%, and had 10 turnovers as Redwick goes to the glass, throws up a prayer, no good. B. Pollock, the weak side rebound. Now gives off to Holland. Rochester in that first half shot 5 of 11 from the floor for 45%, 3 of 5 from behind the arc, and shot, I think they were, 2 of 2 from the free throw line. No, I'm sorry, 3 of 5 from the free throw line and 5 turnovers. Holland, right side, cut off by the defense, a double team, gives a Schroff on the right baseline. Eleni gets a pick from Holland, now works to the wing, works to the right baseline, cut off by the defense, shot is no good, Crispin to the rebound, out to Malco. Malco around the defense, fouled on the shot, she'll go to the line for two.
She's going to be fouled by Jessica Schramm, I believe. That'll be her second, team's first of the second half.
6.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Rochester leads by 4, 33-29. And Abby Malco will go to the line to shoot 2 for the Rochester Lady Zebras.
She's 2 for 2 from the free throw line tonight.
First one for the senior on the way. Good. Austin Shepherd. I'm David Musselman. We are at Rochester High School. Non-conference game. These two teams could meet again come postseason time. Second one by Malco on the way. Good again. 35-29. A little pressure in the backcourt. Redwick runs away from Schroff. Crosses the timeline right, picks up her dribble. Now to Shorter. Now to Schramm. Schramm holds against Holland. Now to Shorter behind the arc, left side up against B. Pollock. One dribble. Picks it up and tries to get the pass to Schramm. Knocked out of bounds by Holland. It'll stay with Winamac here on the near side, right in front of their bench. 35-29, Lady Zebras. Schroff guards the inbounds pass. Schramm gets it in to Redwick. Redwick lobs ahead to Schramm, works against Malco, or makes that Schroff, outside to Redwick. Redwick against Holland, takes her to the baseline, throws up a shot over Ryan Holland, no good, rebound tipped out of bounds, they're going to say last touch by Rochester, it'll stay with Winamac baseline left.
Going to say it went off of Riley Holland.
Riley, don't let her get it back!
So Tony Stasiak giving the officials a what for, Jeff Wagner giving the officials the what for. There's no win, huh?
Ah, poor guys. I don't feel bad for him.
Redwick in the left corner against Holland. Underhand pass to Schramm. Swings right side. Now picked off by Malco. Abby Malco again go in for the left-handed Layup is good, and the lead back to 8 for Rochester with 5:40 to play in the first half, in the third quarter.
Mako just saw that pass all the way cross court, and she had her eyes on it, just like a defensive back, and picks it off, takes it for the 2 points.
And Schramm just spots up for 3 at the top of the key as her defender was backing off when she shot that was in the paint, and that's an easy pickings for Schramm.
I don't think they'll be backing off of Schramm. I think that was Mako guarding Schramm.
Well, nobody was guarding Schramm that time. On the wing is Abby Mako. Dribbles to the top of the key. Now right side to Holland with 5:14 to play in the third quarter. Schroff, she'll fire her own 3. Left baseline's no good. And the rebound to Anspaugh. Katie Anspaugh now with the basketball. Actually, McGovern with the rebound. Now quickly to Schramm. Schramm works against Holland. Right side to Anspaugh. Makes that McGovern behind the arc right side. Back to Schramm with the volleyball line on the right with 4:53 to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 5. And the entry pass is tipped out of bounds by B. Pollock. And it will stay with Winamac baseline right as Bethany Brogdon comes back into the game. Schramm sits down.
Good job by Bree Pollock there. She's doing a really good job. She's a little undersized down there on the block, but she just makes those plays, you know, tips that ball away, doesn't allow the easy layup.
Inbounds pass is tipped away by Mako. She has the ball left side of the floor. Abby Mako stops, pops, nope. Rebound tipped around. Holland has it. Her put back on the way is good off the glass.
Good job by Holland to run the court. She gets the offensive rebound, puts it right back in.
Rochester's lead back to 7 at 39-32. 4.5 to play in the third quarter. McGovern stands behind the arc on the left side, gives to Brogdon top of the key. Now right side is Shorter. Shorter holds against Pollock. Bounce pass to Brogdon. Bethany, back door to Redwick. She is fouled before the shot. It should be on the floor. We'll wait and see, but Jenna Crispin just picked up foul number 3.
Jenna Crispin got out of position there, and she's going to get her 3rd foul, and they're going to say it is on the floor.
Rayanne Hunter will come back into the game, and Jenna Crispin, who's had a lot of bench time tonight, had the first 4 points of the game and then picked up two quick fouls and just picked up foul number 3 right there. Inbounds pass to Shorter to Brogdon. Brogdon looking for Redwick. Nice defense by Holland. Cutting off the passing lane. Now Redwick has it left side behind the arc. Holland kicks the basketball out of bounds as that entry pass going to Shorter, but Riley Holland kicks it out of bounds, and Winamac will try it again. Baseline left underneath their own basket. Lady Zebras by 7 at 39-32. 4 minutes to play in the third quarter. Brogdon holds. Gives to Redwick left side. Redwick. Her pass lobbed down low to Shorter against the triple team. Gets it back to Redwick. Redwick, baseball pass top of the key to Brogdon. Brogdon from 10 foot. She'll put it up. It's off the back of the iron. No good. Rebound loose. Holland picks it up. Riley Holland brings it up the floor. Walking through the center circle. Sends left side to Mako. Mako for 3. In and out. No good. And the rebound by Pollock. The putback is good.
Okay, well, good job by Bree Pollock again. She was able just to get position down there on the low block. Gets the offensive rebound. And easy 2 points for her.
41-32, Rochester on top. Brogdon lobs the pass over to McGovern. Now down low to Shorter. Shorter has it blocked by Hunter. Now leads ahead to Mako. Mako gets the Winamac defense. Shot's no good. A putback by Pollock's no good. And she'll go to the line to shoot 2.
Another job. Bree Pollock trailing Mako. Mako didn't make it. Bree Pollock gets another offensive rebound. Tries to go up. Gets fouled. Going to go to the line here for 2 free throws.
What are her numbers?
She had 2 points in the first. She's got 4 already here in the second half.
And she'll go to the line to shoot 2 with 3:15 to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 9. And B. Pollock, a 5'10 sophomore, at the line for 2. First one's good by the youngster. She'll have 1 more. Lead back to 10 for Rochester. And Schramm back into the game, and McGovern will sit down. Austin Shepherd, I'm David Musselman. We're at Rochester High School in the third quarter. Rochester by 10. B. Pollock looking to push the Zebra lead back to their biggest, which would be 11. Second on the way is good again.
All of her points here in the second half, here, even those, they're coming off a second-chance opportunity.
Yep. 43-32, Rochester on top. Winamac with the basketball. Now Lady Zebras in a 2-3 zone. Schramm splits a double team. Down low to Shorter, has her ball knocked away by Hunter. Mako picks it up. Mako left side of the floor. Mako, left-handed layup, no good off the back of the iron. And the rebound to Shorter, who gives to Redwick. Quickly ahead to Schramm. Schramm's hit some big threes tonight for Winamac, and she stands on the left wing. She'll fire another. Looks good. It's short. And the rebound to Redwick. Her putback is good from 15 feet.
Good job by Redwick there. She follows the play on the far side, gets the long rebound, hits a little 11-foot jump shot.
43-34, Rochester up with 2.5 to play in the third. Winnemac in a 2-3 zone. Holland sends left side to Malco. Malco against Brogdon around the defense. Goes to the basket. Throws up a shot. It's good.
That was a great drive there on the lower lane. And just puts it up strong.
Schramm feeds down low to Anspaugh. We're going to have a foul before the shot. Well, there was no shot, but a foul on the entry pass, I believe, on Rayan Hunter. And it'll be out of bounds to the Winnemac Lady Warriors baseline left. 2:10 to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 11 at 45-34. Schramm looks to get it in. Studies still looking to get it in. Got to have to hurry now and gets it in to Redwick in the left corner. Redwick. Down low to Anspaugh. Her turnaround jumper on the block's no good. And a great block out by B. Pollock. And a foul coming against the Winnemac Lady Warriors.
It's going to be on Shorter. Good job by B. Pollock. Like you said, she is a little bit undersized there, but she's battling for position. Had great position for the rebound. Forced Shorter to go over her back.
2:04 to play in the third. Winnemac trailing the Rochester Lady Zebras by 11, 45-34. Malco will make the Winnemac come out of that 2-3 zone, and it looks like now we'll go to a man-to-man, doesn't it look like?
Yep.
Malco out to Pollock, now to Hunter. Rand Hunter, bounce pass to Holland with a minute 45 to play in the third quarter. B. Pollock behind the arc, left side, looking down low, gets it to Hunter, top of the key, now back to Holland, now to Malco high on the right side. 90 seconds to play in the third. Holland with a long three, no good, and Redwick with the board. Sarah Redwick pushes ahead to Brogdon, now to Anspaugh, and through the hands of Katie Anspaugh and out of bounds, another turnover on Winnemac with 1:23 to play in the third quarter, Rochester by 11.
I tell you what, with Winnemac going back to a man-to-man defense, I think you got to look inside to Rayan Hunter, Bree Pollock.
I agree. Malco just about carried a basketball, no call. Malco inside the arc gives to Pollock, now to Schroep with a minute five. Schroep back to Malco in the left wing. Abby, a couple of dribbles with a minute three, gives to Schroep, back to Holland on the right side. Under a minute to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 11 at 45-34, now to Malco with 55. Malco holds at the volleyball line, now between the rings with 52. Looks back door to Holland. Holland loses the basketball into the hands of Winnemac and Brogdon. Now quickly to Redwick. Redwick then travels. And we'll go back to Rochester on another Winnemac Lady Warrior turnover.
I tell you what, Coach Stasiak playing the four corners there, just trying to run some clock off here in the third quarter, forces a turnover. Winnemac turns the ball right back over to Lady Z's.
McGovern back into the game, and Shorter will sit down. 40 seconds to play, third quarter, Rochester by 11. And Riley Holland will walk the ball up the floor, sends high on the left side to Malco. Malco against Schramm, works around the defense in the paint. Her pass is kicked away down low by Redwick. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left with 28.6 to play in the third.
She tried to feed Bree Pollock down there in the low post.
Malco will trigger it in. Left side, looking. No look pass to Schroep. Schroep on the right baseline. Works against the defense. Skip pass to Malco. Malco in the lane. Stops. Pops off the glass. No good. Hunter with the board. Rand Hunter travels.
Yeah, she shuffled her feet there. Didn't know if she wanted to take it up strong or pass it out. She shuffled her feet. Turns the ball over with 18.3 seconds to go here in the third quarter.
45-34, Rochester on top. And Sarah Redwick with the basketball against Riley Holland walks it through the center circle for the Lady Zebras. Works to the right side. Picks up a dribble. This sends to Brogdon. Down the left corner with eight to Schramm. And she buries a big three with two. Malco ahead. Half quarter at the buzzer. Will be good if it goes. It's no good. After three, Rochester by eight at 45-37. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Hi, at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep, Rochester, every day is the perfect day to go shopping for a new vehicle of your choice. This is John Adair, General Manager. The new 2012s are arriving with new incentives and new styling. We are also offering tremendous rebates on our 2011s. At Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep, we are dedicated to providing our community with the opportunity to drive the vehicle of your choice by offering the most for your trade-in, affordable financing, and customer service that keeps you coming back year after year. At Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep, it's all about you, our customers. Stop by and visit us at 1702 Main Street in beautiful Rochester. And remember, we are the home of the $12.99 oil change. At Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep, you have a friend in the car business.
Feel the energy, Mike Anderson.
WROI. Final quarter here at Rochester High School. The Lady Zebras lead 45-37. Quick stats up to this point, three complete quarters. Rochester 17-43 from the floor, 40%, 6-7 from the free throw line, and just six turnovers to this point in the game. For Winamac, they are 12-30 from the floor, 40%, 8-11 from the free throw line, 73%, and 15 big turnovers for Winamac. As we start the fourth quarter, Lady Warriors with the ball going to our left. Rochester will start in a 2-3 zone. Brogdon, middle of the floor, left side to Schramm. Schramm has had a huge night for the Lady Warriors.
She pretty much carried them the whole third quarter there. She had three threes for nine of their 11 points.
And she has, did you say 15?
She's got 15 total for the game.
So the ball is knocked out of bounds by Rochester. Sarah Redwick will inbound it right in front of her bench. Redwick, bounce pass in, almost stolen by Schroff on the kick. And now both officials look at each other, and Schroff is like, I didn't kick this. What are we doing? And now, inverted whistle, which means Rochester's going to get it on the turnover at the 16th for Winamac.
That actually helped Rochester because the inadvertent whistle. Lane Schroff would have been immediately double-teamed, but now since it's our ball full length of the court, Winamac backs off.
7:40 to play in the game. Rochester by 8. Malco's had a huge game. Abby holds against Schramm. One dribble, gives to Holland on the right wing. Riley Holland, one dribble, back to Malco, left side. Malco backs away inside the arc, bounce pass to Holland. Riley in the paint, on the baseline now to Schroff, and she has it stripped away by Redwick, and it'll stay out of bounds to Rochester as Redwick couldn't save him from going out.
I tell you what, Zelenomac back in this 2-3 zone. Rochester trying to move the ball around the perimeter.
So Malco looks to get it in. She's going to have to hurry and lobs it ahead to Schroff. Elaney against Schramm. Crossover dribble. Takes her inside the arc. Now backs it out. Now on the right wing. Ball loose. Picks up the loose ball. Now gives to Holland. Holland at the free throw line. Down low to Crispin and throws it out of bounds. And it's going to go back to Winamac.
Crispin trying to fight for position down there. She was thrown to the ground. Thought she was fouled a little bit.
Tough entry pass.
Yeah.
7 minutes to play in the game. Rochester by 8, 45-37. Schramm holds on the left side. Here comes the double team. Schramm trying to dribble out of it. It's going to be tied up. It's going to go to Rochester.
Good job by Jenna Crispin to come over to the back, make sure she had all of those, all ball in that, no hand. And even though with three fouls, she's still playing aggressive.
6:58 to play in the game. Rochester up 45-37. And Malco crosses the timeline right. We'll set up shop for the Lady Zebras. Bounce pass cross-court left to Holland. Riley Holland across between the double team gives to Malco right side, looking down low to Smith. Takes her defender to the baseline, now to Schroff. Elaney dribbles on the wing, loses her handle, gives to Holland high on the left side. Back to Schroff, fakes a three. Now in the paint, floater is on the way, it's good.
Good job by Elaney Schroff to get the floater right over the front of the rim.
47-37, Rochester back to 10. With 6:25 to play in the game. Malco make that Brogdon. Gives to McGovern. Back to Brogdon. Baseball pass left side to Redwick, and she travels going to the basket.
Jenna Crispin came out, forced her to take that shot fake, and she shuffled her feet before she get the ball back out on the ground.
17th turnover on the evening for Winamac. Rochester's biggest lead of the night has been 11. They are at 10 right now with 6:10 to play in the game. Lady Zebras going to our right. Holland around the defense. On the block, layup is partially blocked, picked up by Shorter.
Good block by Shorter there.
And now the ball's tipped ahead to Redwick. She saves them going out of bounds, but right into the hands of Holland. Riley Holland down the right side of the floor. Riley Holland will go to the rack, and she's going to be called for a charge. Bethany Brogdon did a great job by holding her ground, and Holland ran her over. That's going to be a turnover on Rochester and a foul on Riley Holland.
That'd be Holland's first foul, team's third.
5:53 to play in the game. Rochester by 10 at 47-37. Sarah Redwick walks it through the center circle against the 2-3 zone. Gives to Brogdon high on the right side. Bethany passes to Shorter. Her pass is tipped away and stolen by Lainey Smith. And now to Schroff. Schroff will take her time and she'll cross the timeline. 5.5 to play in the game. Rochester by 10. Bounce pass to Holland on the right wing. Stands behind the arc. Gets a pick from Crispin. Now sends left side to Schroff. Elaney has her shot blocked by Schramm and now picked up by Shorter ahead to Redwick. Now the no-look pass to Brogdon. Brogdon in the paint, throws up a shot. It is good.
I tell you what, good job by Brogdon to handle that pass. I don't know how she didn't travel there, but she gets a good pass there on the low block.
Bethany Brogdon has her first two of the contest. It's 47-39. Rochester up now by eight. Holland backs away in the lane. Lob pass down to Crispin. Jenna Crispin's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line for two.
And she's going to be fouled by Brogdon, which is going to be her second foul. Crispin's going to line here for her two free throws. First time to line tonight.
After her first free throw, B. Pollock and Rayan Hunter will come back into the game. Also, Katie Anspaugh will come back in for the Winamac Lady Warriors. Jenna Crispin, a 5'8 senior, launches the first one. It's no good. She'll have one more. Holland makes that Hunter back in. And Smith will come out. Anspaugh back in for Winamac, and McGovern will come out. B. Pollock will come back in for Crispin if she makes this free throw. 47-39, Rochester under five to play in the game. Second free throw in and out, no good. And the rebound is shorter, and she gives quickly to Sarah Redwick. Redwick, middle of the floor, between the rings of the volleyball line. Right side to Schramm. She has been hot tonight. Schramm's pass is partially blocked, but picked up by Redwick. She'll fire a long three off the side of the iron, no good. Rebound tipped around by Shorter, and we're going to have a foul on the floor by Rayan Hunter. And it's going to stay with Winamac baseline left with 4:43 to play in the game.
Rayan Hunter picked up her third foul, team's fourth.
Rochester up 47-39. Pollock back into the game, and Crispin will come out. Sarah Redwick will look to get it in baseline left. Schroff will guard the inbounds pass. Delaney, bounce pass into Schramm. Wide open three left corner, no good. And the weak side rebound by Winamac. Brogdon will fire a three. It's good. Bethany Brogdon has five, and the lead is cut to five.
All 5 points here in the fourth quarter by Bethany Brogdon. She decided to turn it on the fourth month.
And the Winamac fans coming to their feet. B. Pollock is going to be fouled on the reach-in by Schramm, and it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester. Easily, Austin could have been tied up.
Easily could have been tied up, but the reason it's not going to be tied up, she only had one hand on the basketball.
Is that right? All right.
Sounded good. Oh, you got to question me like that.
Hunter, not a Holland, sorry. Malco for three in the baseline. Nope, short. And the Ants ball with a rebound. Not it. Redwick quickly to Brogdon. Wide open, just inside the arc. Her jumper's on the way. No good. And Schroff grabs the board. A good tough board by Eleni Schroff with 4 minutes to play in the game. Rochester clinging to a 5-point lead at 47-42.
I tell you what, they need to be careful with the basketball right here, Mus, and try to get a good quality bucket.
Law pass inside to Pollock. Pollock loses it in the paint. And we're going to have a foul coming against Rochester. And it's going to be out of bounds to Winamac with 3:50 to play in the game. And Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
If you're stuck with high monthly car payments and think it's the best you can do, think again. By refinancing your car loan with State Farm Bank, you may save on your monthly payments and have more money to spend on other things. Call State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017 for more information. Jeff will help you see how much you could save by refinancing with State Farm Bank. That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3 minutes, 50 seconds to play in regulation. Rochester leads 47-42. Just moments ago, it was 47-37. But two big buckets by Bethany Brogdon has cut this lead to five.
Cut the lead to five, and Rhian Hunter picks up her fourth foul. She's still in the game. Jenna Christian's going to wait to check in for her here with 3:50 to go in the fourth.
Right after Rochester timeout, the Winamac Lady Warriors will have the basketball going to our left. Redwick will be picked up right at the timeline. Sarah Redwick to the volleyball line, left side to Brogdon. Brogdon saves from going out of bounds, throws it up for grabs, gives to Anspaugh, outside to Redwick, and now we're going to have a foul on, I believe, Schroff. And now, from here on out, Winamac will shoot free throws.
That's going to be the second foul on Schroff. Team six.
Crispin back in. Hunter will sit. 3:38 to play in the game. 47-42 Rochester. Winamac basketball baseline left. And make that Redwick will look to trigger it in. Sarah Redwick. Bounce pass in to Schramm. Schramm with 15 points to Anspaugh. Now to Brogdon, who has five big ones in this quarter. Back to Schramm. Now to Brogdon. Feeds down low to Redwick. Fall away jumper over Schroff is short. And the rebound to Malco, and she is mauled by McGovern. And now Rochester will shoot free throws from here on out.
And first foul on McGovern. That means a team six for Winamac. So both teams now with 3:24 to go in the fourth will be at the free throw line with any fouls.
Malco will walk it up the floor. She'll be picked up by Redwick. 3:18 to play in the game. Malco, middle of the floor, has her pocket picked by Redwick. Sarah Redwick is fouled before she gets to the basket. Great headsy move by the senior, Abby Malco, who fouled Redwick before she got the shot off, and that'll mean Sarah Redwick will now go to the line, shoot one of the bonus. Winnemac calling for an intentional,
but
basically she just bodied her up.
Yeah, she basically just put a little bit of shoulder on her. Definitely not an intentional foul. Should be the 1-on-1 bonus for Redwick.
Sarah Redwick, a 5'6 senior at the line to shoot one of the bonus. Her number's also tonight.
Redwick's sitting with 8 points.
First free throw, no good. Crispin to the big board. Jenna clears now to Shrove. 3:10 to play in the game. Rochester up 47-42. Shrove against Schramm. Man-to-man defense. Right side, bounce pass to Crispin. Crispin around the defense. She'll go to the rack. Down low to Holland. Holland now to Crispin. Her jumper on the way is no good. Falls off the rim. And now we're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to go to Winnemac as Holland and McGovern tied up down low, and Winnemac going to get it back down by just 5 with 2:49 to play in the fourth quarter, and Winnemac will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Culligan man has asked me to talk to you about your water. Are there rusty stains in your sink, and does your water smell and taste bad? Then it's time to call your Culligan man and ask about a Culligan water filtration system,
right?
Because clean water doesn't smell, but contaminants do. A Culligan system eliminates the elements that stain sinks and tubs while reducing corrosion and buildup in fixtures and appliances so they'll last longer and save you some serious dollars. Right now, try a Culligan system for only $9.95 a month for the first 6 months. Call 574-223-2420 and say, "Hey, Culligan man." That's 574-223-2420, or visit CulliganFultonCounty.com. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2 minutes, 49 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 47-42. Full court press by the Lady Zebras as Winnemac gets it in to Redwick. Redwick against the double team, runs right around the double team and goes to the baseline, and she's going to be fouled by Riley Holland, and that's going to be Redwick will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
It's going to be the second foul on Riley Holland. Redwick tonight, she is 3 of 5 from the free throw line.
Shorter back into the game, and Ansball comes out. 2:44 to play in the game. Rochester by 5, and Redwick could cut into this league big time here with 2 freebies. Sarah Redwick ready. First free throw is good as it rolls around and falls through. One more coming for the senior. 47-43 Rochester. 2:44 to play in the game. Redwick for the Lady Warriors with one more. Sets herself, fires a second one, good again. 47-44. That 10-point lead is cut to 10 on a 7-0 run by the Lady Warriors. Holland lost ahead to Shrove, back to Riley Holland, back to Eleni Shrove. Shrove around the defense, works to the block, down low to Crispin. Crispin back to Shrove, gives to Holland. Holland between the rings with 2:25 to play in the game. Works against Brogdon. Holland in the lane, gives to Shrove. Shrove then is going to be called for a travel.
That was a tough call because I didn't think she had possession of the basketball and they called for the travel.
Tough pass by Holland right at the feet of Shrove. That's a tough one to handle. Turnover Rochester, and Winnemac with this possession could tie things here at 47 with a big 3-point bomb with 2:10 to play in the game. Redwick almost loses the basketball, picks it up, gives outside to Schramm. Schramm around the defense, works to the wing to Redwick. Her long three for the tie is short, and Crispin to the board, and McGovern's going to pick up a foul, and Jenna Crispin will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Good job by Jenna Crispin to block out McGovern. McGovern had no choice but to do the over and back there. And Jenna Christman's going to go to the line here for the 1-on-1. She's 0 for 2 from the free throw line tonight. And must we have not scored a basket. I got to think right around the 5-minute mark when Eleni Shrove hit that little floater in the front of the rim.
And really nobody looking for their shot. They're just kind of running around hoping the clock gets to zero before Winnemac ties it up or even takes the lead. I guess that's my feeling. Crispin's free throw, no good. In and out. She is 0 for 3 her last two trips. And now Winnemac with the basketball. Redwick up the floor, quickly to Shorter. Back to Sarah Redwick. Now left side to Brogdon and throws to a Heiner and out of bounds. Got to go back to Rochester. Coming up after this one, the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance Player of the Game. And also we'll have the Nubiana's Pizza Trivia question as well. Stay tuned for that.
Can I win?
Nope. Not tonight.
Oh, man.
Falco gets the basketball. Stands at the top of the key. Abby against the double team. Splits the double team. Works to the lane. Wrap around pass to Pollock. Her jumper's good.
Good job by Abby Malco. What a way to go right to through the middle of the defenders. Wraps it around to Bree Pollock, and we needed that layup.
49-44. Rochester back by five with Schramm top of the key. Works against Schroep. Left side to Brogdon. Brogdon against Malco. Gives to Shorter. Shorter outside to McGovern. McGovern behind the arc with a minute 20 to play in the game. To Shorter. Back to McGovern. Down low to Redwick. Redwick against a double team. Fallaway jumpers in and out and back in. And it's 49-46.
Hey, that little fadeaway jump shot, Mus, is just so hard to defend, especially when you got touch like Redwick does.
30-second timeout by the Lady Zebras. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Smith Sawyer and Smith Insurance Agency, Rochester, is your trusted choice agent. They are committed to treating you as a person and not just a policy. A trusted choice agency has access to multiple insurance companies offering competitive pricing and a broad choice of products. Call at 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location, 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website, smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer, Smith Insurance, providing insurance for individuals and groups since 1932.
Zebra basketball, WROI.
A minute 9 to play in regulation. Rochester leads 49-46. It'll be Rochester basketball going to our right after their timeout. On the floor for the Lady Zebras, Hunter, Pollock, Schroep, Malco, and Holland. On the floor for Winnemac, McGovern, Shorter, Brogdon, Schramm, and also Redwick. Schroep gets it into Hunter, who saves him going out of bounds right into the hands of Holland. Now a loose ball. And now Malco's going to pick up a foul, and that's going to send Shorter to the line for one of the bonus.
I tell you what, Coach Stasiak is furious. Holland went for that loose ball and got clocked with a no call, and he's got a little bit of an argument there, Mus.
So Shorter will go to the line for one and the bonus with 65 seconds to play in the game. Rochester clinging to a three-point lead at 49-46.
Number 24.
Abby Malco just picked up foul number three. So Stephanie Shorter at the line for one of the bonus. It's in and out and no good. B. Pollock with a huge rebound. Now to Schroep, and she has it stripped out of bounds by Shorter with a minute two to play in the game.
Okay, Winnemac's obviously going to stay in this man-to-man full-court press, so we got to do something, obviously, get this ball into a ball handler's hand.
And Malco has it. And now Bethany Brogdon picks up the foul. That's going to send Malco to the line for one of the bonus with 60 seconds to play in the game.
Third foul on Brogdon. Malco going to go to the line here. And Mus, she's not the person you want to send the line. She's 4-for-4 tonight. A fourth foul.
Jenna Crispin will come back into the game, and she'll replace Rayanne Hunter with 1 minute, exactly, 60 seconds to play in the game. Abby Malco, the senior, at the line to shoot one of the bonus for the Lady Zebras. 49-46 Rochester. Time running out here in this basketball game. First one for the senior. Good. That's a big one. Winnemac needs it now twice. Again, with 60 seconds to play in the game. Rochester now up by four, 50-46. Malco ready. Sets herself for the second one. Lets her fly. Short. Rebound to McGovern, who gives to Shorter. Now to Redwick. A four-point lead for Rochester with 55 to play in the game. Redwick high on the right side will set up the offense for Winnemac. Now to Brogdon. Brogdon left side to Schramm. And then Schramm travels. Another turnover on Winnemac with 48.6 to play in the game. And now you got to think that if Rochester can get this in bounds off, then they're going to foul immediately as Winnemac.
Yeah, definitely. You want to look to get the ball. I would obviously look to Lady Schroep, Malco, or Holland. Or you got Bree Pollock here, who's 2-for-2 from the line tonight.
That's right. Now Tony Stasiak will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At your neighborhood BP stations, we're focusing on the little things that add up to make a big difference for you. That's why all grades of BP gasoline with Invigorate help your car get a few more miles per tank when compared to low-quality gasoline. When used continuously, it helps clean and protect critical engine parts, so you can go a little farther between fill-ups. And going farther is a little thing that can add up to something big, like another road trip. Fill up at your local BP and see how getting the little things right makes all the difference.
Get smooth one-coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one-coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Enyard's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
48.6 to play in the game. Rochester up 50 to 46. It'll be Rochester basketball going to our right. Eleni Srope will look to get it inbounds with a full court press staring the Lady Z's right in the face. Srope looks to get it in. Lob ahead to Holland. Holland on the one on two. Stops and had the ball kicked away by Shorter. What a great trailer there by Shorter, who kicked it away.
What a great design inbound play against that press. Stasiak got the two-on-one situation there. Almost had the easy dish off to Pollock.
And now Pollock is fouled as the ball immediately comes in bounds, and B. Pollock will go to the line to shoot one in the bonus with 43.9 to play in the game. Rochester up 50-46, and Jenna Crispin will come back into the game for Rayanne Hunter.
Foul's going to be on McGovern, her third, team's ninth. So there's still a one-on-one bonus here for Bree Pollock, where she's two for two tonight.
Austin Shepherd, I'm David Musselman. We're at Rochester High School. Lady Zebras and Lady Warriors, I don't think they've disappointed. This one is expected to be a good one, and it has been from word go. Pollock's first one on the way. No good. And the rebound to Shorter, who gives a Redwick with 40. Sarah Redwick, crossover dribble, almost has her pocket picked by Shrove. Picks it back up high on the right side with 35. Ball is tipped away by Malco, and it's going to stay with the Winnemac Lady Warriors baseline left. With 33.4 to play in the game, Rochester by four. Rayanne Hunter will come back into the game, and B. Pollock now will sit. 33.4 to play in the game, Rochester by four. Winnemac basketball baseline left underneath their own basket. Tram gets it into Shorter. Now to Brogdon, high on the right side to Redwick with 30. Redwick, spot up three on the way. Good!
Oh, I tell you what, she had the ball swatted away, able to regain it and hit a big three down to a one-point lead.
And now we're going to have a foul on Sarah Redwick. With 19.7 to play in regulation, Rochester up 50-49, and Abby Malco will go off to the other end of the floor and shoot two free throws.
Is it Abby Malco or Shrove?
Malco. Shrove was inbounding.
Was it?
Which I thought was a pretty cheap call on against Sarah Redwick, to be honest with you.
So Malco going to go online tonight. She's 5-6. 10th team foul against Winnemac. 9th team foul.
Abby Malco will go to the line for one in the bonus with 9 team fouls.
I got fooled by the scorekeeper again.
Which is even more important here for Winnemac. Malco ready. The senior sets herself. Fires the first one. It's good as it hits the front of the rim and rolls over. She'll have one more to look to push this lead to three with 19.7 to play in the game. Rochester up 51-49. Malco ready. The senior sets herself, fires the second one. Good again. And now Winnemac will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The winning edge has spirit. How about you? Now's the time to order your letter jackets to ensure everything is perfect in time for Christmas. Available for all area schools. Don't forget winter sports gear, including stadium chairs, basketball and wrestling equipment. The winning edge also has new shoestring hoodies, winter scarves and hats, and even zebra pin boots, gym bags, and sleepwear. New Under Armour apparel is here, too. Stop by the winning edge for quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service. Raw Place Drive, next to Pizza Hut in Rochester. That's the winning edge.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
19.7 to play in the game. Rochester's lead now is 3 at 52-49. Rochester has 2 timeouts left. Winnemac has 3. It'll be Winnemac basketball underneath the Rochester basket, Austin. They'll need to go the length of the floor.
Need to go the length of the floor, and after the two big free throws by Malco, I would think there's only two people that can get the basketball right now, and that's Schrammer Redwick.
I would agree. Yeah, and here's the other question. Even though it is a two-shot foul, do you foul before Redwick or Schramm is able to get the three off?
No.
No?
I don't like
you
that.
You roll the dice, huh? Take your chances.
Yeah. Yeah, I know that's been more of a common play nowadays, especially when you're down three in a especially since there's no time clock and shooting clock in high school. They can actually wait and take the last shot. But no, I think you just play good, solid, straight-up defense here and make sure you come out on the shooters like Coach Stasiak says. And if the ball goes down into the post, make sure you don't foul on the shot.
Sure. Redwick has it with 17. Redwick outside of Brogdon with 14. Brogdon holds with 11. Brogdon, one dribble, gives their side. It's intercepted by Holland with 8. And Holland is fouled by Sarah Redwick, and Riley Holland will go to the line to shoot 2 with 6.3 to play in the game.
Must, we didn't see it there, but I tell you what, great defense on Elaney Strope. They ran a double pick for Schramm, and Strope caught on, cheated out, and prevented Schramm from getting the ball. Great job by Elaney Strope.
So Riley Holland, who has been pretty quiet tonight scoring-wise, will go to the line to shoot 2 shots. Rochester up 52-49. Free throw by the junior is no good. She'll have one more, and basically, Austin, a must-make for Rochester.
Yeah, you really need that four-point lead here. You need the two-possession ball game.
52-49. Holland with one more from the charity stripe for Rochester. The junior sets herself. Second one's good this time. And now Winamac will use another 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Paint in half the time with new paint and primer in one from Clark and Kenningston. Available exclusively at Ace. You'll get top quality, easy-to-use paint and help that can only come from your neighborhood Ace. People who know their stuff will be right there to help you pick the perfect shade from Clark and Kenningston's harmonious color palette. So you can get your weekend back with Clark and Kenningston's paint and primer in one. Exclusively at Ace, the helpful place. You can find all of your Ace paints at Smith Farm Stores of Rochester and Plymouth.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
6.3 to play in the game. Rochester now up 53-49. And Winamac will have the basketball. They use their timeouts. They'll need to go the length of the floor. They have 2 timeouts left. Rochester has 2 timeouts left. Austin, you apply a little pressure. Don't foul. Let them shoot a 3 if they want it.
I think you let them shoot a 3 if they want it this early. I don't think you pick up pressure to the volleyball court line, which is halfway between the half court and the three-point line. I don't think you put any pressure on until there.
Apparently you were in the Rochester huddle because the Lady Zebra defense is at the Winamac volleyball line, or at the Winamac free throw line. 6.3 to play in the game. Rochester by 4, and they're going to get the basketball inbounds. And they're going to call another timeout. 5. No, they're not. Yep, they are. Winamac will use another timeout with 3.6 to play in the game. We'll keep it right here. They're down to 1 timeout left. 3.6 to play. Winamac trails the Rochester Lady Zebras by 4 at 53-49. Again, coming up after this one, we'll have the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance WROI Player of the Game. And we'll also have the New Biana's Pizza Trivia question as well.
You know, with 3.6 seconds to go, they're going to have it pretty much at half court here as Winamac. Now is the time where if you're Coach Stasiak, those girls will sit back in maybe that 2-3 zone again. And with 3.6 seconds to go, he maybe lets them fire up a quick 3.
That's right. Don't forget, coming up, our next broadcast will be Tuesday night as the Lady Zebras have a day to prepare for the Culver Lady Cavaliers. And we'd like to see a full house up there at Culver, but if you can't make it, we'll have that broadcast for you. Brad Thomas and I will be at that game. Notre Dame must be down, huh?
Yes. Oh, sorry.
Did you hear it?
No, but Stasiak's a little upset with Coach Brash.
Well, I can't hardly blame him. I didn't hear the score, but I know Stasiak just gave Coach Brash one more.
Hopefully Stanford's up by 8.5 or more.
Brogdon looks to get it in. Does so to Schramm. A long 3, the volleyball line is short. Draws nothing but there, and that'll do it. The final tonight from Rochester High School. The Lady Zebras hold on to win 53-49. Coming up, post-game show after this on 92.1 WROI.